Good morning and welcome dear students to Online English Studio class. In today's class, we are going to start Unit 9, that is Dusk, which is written by M.M. Munro. This writer is also known by Saki. Actually, by Saki, he is more famous for, okay. So, without waste of time, let us begin the class, student. So, first, I just want to tell you something more about the writer. You know that H.H. Munro was a Scottish journalist and a writer. His pen name was Saki, okay. So he was a Scottish journalist and a writer whose pen name was Saki. He was also known for writing witty stories which were set in the early 20th century and poked fun at society. He was considered the master of short story. So student, here this writer is very famous for writing stories that was set of 20th century. And his stories are the poked fun. He is just making a mock on the society. What was the real condition of society? He just tries to give in his writing. So without waste of time, let us begin the class. Okay, first of all, I just want to tell you something about dusk. What is dusk? So you know that dusk is not evening. Dusk is that part in which means that is near about the evening, when the evening is about to be. Just before a time there when the sun there is sunset, and then after a little light and a little darkness. So that time, that means the evening going to start, that is called dusk, okay. So I just want to tell you that this story is basically belongs to an old man. This person whose name is Norman Godspy. Okay, then there is an old man which is just besides this man, and after that there we have a young man in this story. So let us begin the story with the text. So student, here is the text. If you have your book, it's better to open open it. So it says that Norman Godspy sat on the park bench on early March evening. It was 30 minutes past 6 and dusk had fallen heavily. Okay, 30 minutes past, just wait, okay, 30 minutes past as at evening means, now it is 6:30 in the evening, and now the evening is going to have the roads and sidewalks. Okay, student, what sidewalks? So sidewalks is given in your book, that is footpath, okay. Were looked empties occupied and with silent figure that moved through the half light or sat quietly on chair on benches, so that they melted into the shadow. Melted into the shadow means they sat so still in the darkness at one no could see them. So these things symbolizes the darkness and the misfortune of the people, no, that the writer is talking about, okay. Dusk to Godspy mind was the hour of defeated. Here dusk is according to the man whose name was Norman Godspy. For that dusk is what? It is a hour of defeated. Okay, he sympathize. Let me make it bigger, student. Just wait. Okay, so he sympathized with them, men and women who fought and lost life's battle came forth in the gloomy hour of dusk. So he thought that here the men and people, those people who come here, they are somewhere defeated in their life. So that is why they come in the darkness, they come in the dusk, so that people could not see them. Clear? Okay, when their shabby clothes, means dirty clothes, and unhappy eyes might pass and unnoticed, means people could not notice them. And just beyond on the other side where he sat were rows of the window from which shone bright lights and cut through the darkness of the evening. Just opposite side where they were sitting, there was a light coming from the window that shows what? Forcing it away. To Godspy mind, it seems that these brilliant lights marks the abodes. What is abodes? So abodes is a place of resident. Okay, so the resident from where the lights were coming, they are belonging to the person who had never had to admit defeat through life's struggle. Okay, means the people from their house, their resident lights were coming. He is according to normal God's spy that they are not defeated any time in their life. Thus, did God's mind imagine these things as he sat on the bench in the near deserted sidewalk? He was sitting sidewalk and then after thinking these things. Okay. On the bench by his side sat an elderly gentleman with a dropping shoulder. Okay. At the same time, there was another man, an old man came and he sat there. But there was a certain daring in his face. His clothes were not shabby, but one would not expect him to wear a carnation in his buttonhole. Okay, carnation is what? A type of flower that was pinned through the bottom holes of the collar of a stylish and fashionable gentleman in the 20th and 90th century. Actually, what happened in 20th and 90th century, that if the person who is a rich, they have a fashion to have a pin in their coats. Okay, they just have a flower as a pin in their coats. So he is telling that he is looking like rich, but his eyes is not happy somewhere. Okay, as he rose to go, God's wife imagined him returning to a home circle where nobody cared for him. He got up and walked away. He did not say anything to the man who sat nearby. Means they both were not talk to each other anything. After some time, the man stood up and he walked away. When he saw the man, he thought that there might be a problem, that at his home nobody is going to care of the man, so that is why he is looking like rich person, no? But he had his eyes is saying that nobody going to care for him. That is why he came at this time and sitting here. Okay. Next paragraph. His figure vanished slowly into the shadow. His place on the bench was soon taken by a young man, fairly well dressed, but with a sour look. Okay, what is sour look? Sour look means a disappointed and unpleasant expression. Sour look and disappointed. As soon as the man stood up, there was a young man came and then he sat on the same place. But he was looking rich, fair and well dressed, but he was looking unpleasant. He uttered an angry groan and he flung himself into the seat. He was somewhere looking anger. Then after, "You don't seem to be a good temper," said Godspy. The young man turned to him and said, "You wouldn't be a good temper if you are in the fix I am. I have done the silliest thing ever in my life." Okay, he asked that what happened that you are not looking in a good temper. He told that if you would be on my place, your temper also look like me. And what things that I did here today, that the silliest thing I did not do, in my whole life. Okay. What have you done? Asked Godspy. "Came up to London this afternoon. I thought of staying at Patagonian Hotel at Berkshire Square," said the young man. So he's saying that I'm just coming from London. I was thinking that I will be staying in a hotel whose name was Patagonian Hotel. Okay, but what happened? "When I got there, I found I had been pulled down in the place of the hotel in a cinema theater had come up. The taxi driver took me to the another hotel same way off where I could stay. And I at once sent a letter to my people giving them the address. Then I went to buy some soap. I'd forgotten to pack any, and I hate using hotel soap." Okay, so he's saying that in which hotel I have to go, I somewhere forgot the right way of that, and my taxi driver has sent me to another hotel. Thereafter also what happened? I just wanted to buy another soap because I really do not like to using the soap that is available in the hotel. So I just wanted to, I went and I buy it. But what happened? I forget to pack any. So that is why I just having short temper and not, I'm not happy what I did. Okay. Then after, when I turned my, just wait. when I just wait, student. Okay, so we were here in paragraph 8. Okay, so again he said, when I turned to my steps back to the hotel, I suddenly realized that I didn't remember the name of the hotel or even what street it was. Okay, when he turned to step to back for the hotel after buying the shop or the soap, then after he was saying that he could forgot the name of the hotel and the right path actually where he has to go. I have no friends in London. I could write to my people for the address, but they will get my letter only tomorrow. Meantime, I'm without any money. Came out with shilling. Shilling is what? Shilling is a student. That shilling is also a unit of money which was used in Britain. In my pocket. So he's saying that I'm now without money. No money is there in my pocket. Okay, so that I could buy a shop and I can drink anything. Here I am wandering about with the 2 pence in my pocket, and now we are going to go for the night. So he's thinking that now I have to I have to stay there in this night today. Means he, the worst condition, the man is trying to say, the man, the old person, Mr. Norman. So all about the story, what he had heard heard by the old man, Mr. Norman Godspy, to the young man. Okay, then after what happened, the story was followed by a long equivalent pause. I suppose you think I have a spun off your impossible yarn. Okay, so equivalent is what? Equivalent is significant, and then after the spun off your an impossible yarn is a told by unbelievable story. So here the man is saying that Norman Godspy is saying that I could not, he's saying in himself that I could not believe in this story, because his story is not what he has told. It is unbelievable story. Okay, not at all impossible, said Godspy. I remember doing a similar thing for foreign capital. So he is not going to believe what he has told. Okay. Okay, thereafter. But on that occasion, there was two of us. We remembered luckily the hotel on a smaller canal. After some search, we had found the canal. We found that. Okay, so here he is also telling the story that once we have, the man whose name was Godspy, he and one of his friend also went to the foreign capital. The similar condition he was saying, but he's saying that there was a difference between your story and my story, that you are alone today, but I was one of my friend there, and somewhere anyhow I just found the hotel. Again he says, a foreign country, it would be difficult. I could go to the consul. Okay student, what is consul? So consul is an officer that is appointed by a country government to live in a foreign country and set to protect. Okay, so they are the officer for the help of the people if they just need any types of help. So the consul are to be helped for the people. Okay, here unless I find a decent chap who could believe my story and lend me some money, I will have to spend my night perhaps on embankment. What is embankment, student? So it is a area in London on the bank of the river on Thames. So that on that area he's saying that if nobody is going to help me, I have to stay there and spend my night there on the bank of the river Thames. Okay, have you got the soap with you? Godspy asked. Okay, thereafter what he told. The young man at once sat forward, felt rapidly in his pocket of the overcoat, then jumped into his feet. I must have lost it, he muttered. He was searching here and there in himself, but he could not find the soap. And then he told that I lost soap as well. Godspy said, the weak point in your story is that you are unable to produce the soap to lose a hotel. And a cake of soap on an afternoon suggests willful careless. Okay, willful careless means deliberate. It means what you have done, it shows that you have done it willingly. So there is no, he's thinking that this man is making me fool. When the young man heard this remark, he hurried away from the path he had held. Okay, he ran from there. Then after what happened? It was a pity. Goswami thought with a smile, it's the going to get one's own soap was the one convinced touch in the whole story, and yet it was just a little detail which didn't help him. If he had been clever enough to provide himself with a cake of soap wrapped and sealed at the chemist council, he would have genius in his profession. So here somewhere Goswami is able to catch the man, that whatever he's saying, that he just making a false story to me so that he can take money from me. But he said that if he could able to manage the soap, maybe he just succeeded in this story and I could give the money to the man. With this thought, Goswami got up to go, and he did so. He let out an exclamation of surprise and sympathy. Lying on the ground under the bench with a small over a pocket wrapped and sealed, it was a cake of soap. It must have fallen out of the young man's overcoat pocket when he flung himself down to the seat. So he found a pack of soap there. He thought that it must be of the man who was telling me the story. So he believed that the story is somewhere true after finding the soap. Okay. Yeah, now 18. The next moment, Goswami was running along the dust-covered path, the anxious in search of young youthful figure in the light. In the light overcoat, he nearly gave the search when he caught the sight of him standing on the border of the carriage drive. Goswami hailed him. Okay, Goswami hailed him. So after a few miles away, he just got the man, and then after he hailed him. Hailed means he called him. The important witness of the truth of the story has turned up, said Goswami, holding out of the cake of soap. It must have sell from your overcoat pocket as you sat down on the seat. I found it on the ground after you left. I didn't believe your story. You must excuse me for that, but the appearance. Okay, so he was saying that I was not believing on your story, what you are just saying to me, but after getting this soap I could believe you. And he also said sorry for that, so that he could not believe his story. Okay. Of the soap exchanged, of the soap changed everything, and now my doubts are gone. The loan of a Severian in any good for you? The young man took the coin as hastily pocket. Okay, so he has given a sovereign. Sovereign is what? An old British coin. It is a coin. So he was given him a coin, and the man was taken it in hastily and he kept it in his pocket. Okay. Then he says, here's my card with the address, continued Goswami. Any day of this week you can return the money. Here is the address in the shop. Don't lose it again. It's been a good friend of you. Okay, so he has given him a card and told that if you have, I mean, any day if you have money, you can return me on this address. Okay, luckily you found it, said the young man, and blurting out a word or two of thanks he fled. And then after getting blurting out, means saying something without thinking. What he is saying that is without thinking, and then after he fled from there. Poor boy, he nearly broke down, said Goswami to himself. So Goswami is saying that bechara aadmi, a poor boy, what he has done, that is a bad thing. As Goswami retraced his steps, retraced his steps means walked back the same way from there he had come, past the seat where the drama had taken place. In the same place he reached there, he found an elderly gentleman poking the ground with his stick beneath the seat. What he found, that at the same place, the same young gentleman was whose description was given in the beginning of the story. He was sitting there. Actually, he was poking with his stick to the ground and realized that it was earlier fellow. He just recognized that it was the earlier fellow, the man who was coming in before the young person. Have you lost anything, sir? So he asked. So Gotsbai asked the man, have you lost anything, sir? Yes, sir, a cake of soap. The man politely replied that yes, I have lost my cake of soap. So actually the soap was belonging to the old man, okay, to the old man, not to the young man. But what God's, according to God's, Gotsbai, he just made fool with the man. So in this case, the writer Saki is giving the portrait of the society, that how the people is using different tricks to make others foolish, no? To make others fool, and their foolish activities is somewhere succeeded by the man to God's wife. So story is now finished here. In the next class, student, we will just wait. Okay. So here the story is finished, and student, in the next class, I will discuss you the question answer of this story based on the chapter. So till that time, student, thank you so much and have a nice time.